Hello, my name is Pablo Mazzilli, and in this presentation I want to tell you a bit about this new feature that we are including in GeneXus 18, which is the possibility of building a full solution for super apps and mini apps. We're going to go through the different benefits that this kind of solutions offers to users, and especially the business opportunities that this gives to companies and those that provide this kind of solution. Now we will see a little bit about what super apps are. We're going to go through an overview of the status of super apps and what it means to create a solution of this kind, and how easy you will find it to develop this kind of solutions in GeneXus and quickly respond to the demand that you will get for this kind of application. So what is a super app? A super app is basically, broadly speaking, a single application that offers various services of a different nature that are not necessarily related to each other, but they do coexist within the same application. Through a unified and more personalized experience, users can then resolve different activities or daily needs through these services. These services are given through applications, and these applications are dynamically loaded in that main application or host application. Companies are adopting super apps to gain a competitive advantage. In this way, they can have more loyalty from the clients, and with that knowledge, they can give more personalized services. This was something that began in Asia, more precisely in China, but that is expanding to the rest of the world. And we can see in the West that companies are seeking to be positioned as the next super app. We see that in the media every day, where different companies are offering different super app solutions so that they can position themselves in this segment of the market. If we take a look at the super app market, we can classify that in two main categories. First, we can say that they are applications that add multiple services through features that are incorporated in the very application. And the difficulty that this presents is that those applications cannot scale up in terms of services because that application gets bigger. And the way to overcome that, or the way in which it has been overcome by many applications, is by adding payment or marketplace services in their own platforms. So we see how applications, delivery applications, for example, they can add package delivery options or shopping in certain shops, or messaging companies or applications will add delivery services or carpool services. So as we set the difficulties, how can you scale up in terms of services? We also have applications that opened up their platform, that initially went through this process, which is the case of Alichat or WePay, that they were applications with a very specific purpose. WeChat was a messaging application that began to incorporate services in their own application. And they went one step forward and they opened up their application for third parties to directly incorporate services through their platform. This kind of applications allow you to scale up to the infinity because the services that you find are dynamically loaded depending on the user's needs. And that means that they can be leveraged by third parties, by services given by third parties. So they will give you a better user experience and they will generate new business opportunities. Of course, the challenge that this kind of solution presents is a greater challenge, not only in terms of the business itself and from a commercial standpoint, to get this kind of partnership with the different solution providers so that you can build that ecosystem, but from a technological standpoint, because it means that an application needs to open up its application, its platform, and dynamically load services that will be given by other companies. In GeneXus, we have been developing the technology to generate this kind of solution, and nowadays it is a reality with GeneXus 18. You can build this kind of solution with GeneXus 18, and when we talk about building a super app solution with GeneXus, we specifically mean building a super app or convert an app into a super app that will be able to load as many mini apps as necessary depending on the ecosystem or the businesses that you're talking about, and those mini apps will be dynamically loaded. That means that they will not be previously installed in the device, but rather they will be on demand and upon users' discretion, they will be loaded and executed as native applications. These mini apps can be developed internally or through partners, through third parties. So we're going to see some examples of applications, some of which are real case examples, and some are based on real cases that we're working on so that we can give you an overview of the different benefits that this kind of solution brings. A typical case where you can see this kind of solution and where we think that you could that it would be very feasible and very positive to have this kind of solution is, for example, for financial institutions. Imagine that you have a financial institution's application that you can make, that you can use to make payments. And by opening up the platform and making it into a super app, they can invite different shops or brands or stores to develop mini apps, and they can be integrated into that super app. So they would be integrating services such as, for instance, payments for the different products. So shops could easily develop those mini apps, which has many advantages for the different parties involved. First of all, for the financial institution, because all payments are processed through their platform. And for businesses, they can offer their businesses in an already established ecosystem. So they could have their own application in the store, as, for example, a ticketing application. But they also want to have a mini app version that will be running in the super app of this financial institution. This gives the user great advantages because the shopping experience of users is different. It's not the same to buy, for example, a cup of coffee or a ticket for a show or to buy a TV. So through mini apps and with their own user experiences, we can give that differentiated value. Another great advantage for users is that it's not necessary to download each of these applications from the different stores, but they're going to be dynamically loaded when they need them from the super app. So you don't need to register, and you don't need to register your payment methods, because all payments will be done by the super app that already has that information, and that is the application that you trusted to begin with and you gave all the information to, with of course all the security and privacy levels that you need. Another scenario that we think is very feasible to apply this is at government level. So you can have, for example, a local government application where all the different kinds of services given to citizens can be accessed through one super app. So instead of, for instance, going to one website and finding all the services and getting lost amongst so much information, you can give citizens applications that will be specific to them and what they need. Another typical scenario for this kind of solution that also allows this kind of architecture is the incremental development of a solution. Let's think, for example, of an application that is used internally in a company, such as, for example, Start Me Up, which is used by Globant collaborators. It's an internal social network with all the information of collaborators. And you also have some other satellite applications, such as, for example, the benefits that employees have, or, for example, expenses when people are traveling. So all these applications that are satellite could be incorporated into the super app. And you could develop an application in an incremental way through modules that are decoupled from the rest. This means that the application makes a lot of sense without having to make it bigger, because services will not be previously installed in the main application, but they will be loaded according to each user's needs. Another example that I wanted to tell you about is an application for an event. This was an event that took place in Colombia a couple of months ago. It's the Tekken Fest. And GeneXus participated in a Globant event with a stand. And the event had an application with information about the speakers and the different topics and lectures and timetables and so on. And what we wanted is to have in the GeneXus stand the possibility to give people that were physically present at that place that by reading a QR code, they could register for a lottery. So instead of building a new application that users had to download in their applications, what we did was to transform the events application into a super app. And with the camera, you could read the QR code that was in the GeneXus stand in that event, and that automatically gave them a new icon that gave them the possibility to have access to that mini app. So when users went to that mini app, they could trigger an application where you could register for the raffle, for the lottery, so that you could see the winner's information later on. So the main super app application was used not only by the people that were attending physically that event, but also for anyone that was attending the event, even online. But those that were physically in that place would have access to this application, this mini app, to participate in that lottery. So this, of course, gives you new business models and options that you can give your users with applications that are feasible or that can be used at specific times or specific places. So let's see how we can build a super app with GeneXus. and in particular, what is new with GeneXus 18. In GeneXus, we're giving you the possibility to build a full mini-app and super-app solution, which includes super-apps, mini-apps, and also the mini-app center. This is the repository or the platform where you're going to be registering and writing about all the mini-apps, and that super-apps will have access to that so that they can see what are the valid mini-apps for a certain application. So in this first version that we included in GeneXus 18, the first scenario that we wanted to tackle was to build any native application into a super app. In other words, that any native application that was developed or not with GeneXus can become a super app. So it means that those applications that are popular, that have a good user adoption, can become a super app without having to do a full rework or reprogramming all the application. So what are the steps to build a super app solution? Let's go step by step in terms of the different components that will be necessary to develop this kind of solution with GeneXus. As I was telling you, one of the main components is the super app in itself. So for that, you will find it easy to turn an app into a super app. And the first step to do so is to incorporate a module that we're calling the GeneXus Render. This is a licensed product that will give that application the capacity to become a super app. In other words, to dynamically load many apps. That module is available for Android and iOS, and you can incorporate it in your project very easily through different examples that we will be giving you and a lot of documentation that you will find available. The second step is to get the list of mini apps. So you want that application to get the mini app list, and they will be cataloged in the mini app center. So that module that I was telling you about will have the capacity to access an API that will give you the mini app list that are suitable for this super app or that were developed for the super app. The third step is to design the user interface that you will have for users so that they can discover and have access to those super apps. The API that will return the list of mini apps has different features. It can give you a full mini app list, so you can present it as you see it on the screen as a list, a horizontal list, or as you may deem convenient for your users. You also have the possibility to get the mini apps list that will be relevant for a certain time frame. So when you're cataloging a mini app, you can say, well, this mini app will be valid for a certain period of time, or for example, in a certain time frame, or at this on this date. So you can use that mini app to apply a discount, for example, on a specific date. And last, you can have access to the mini apps list depending on the location, those that are closer to the user. If, for example, it's related to a brick and mortar's shop, you can get a list for mini apps that are closer to that user. So if you get closer to a shopping center, for instance, you can see that super app, which will be showing you the mini apps that will be close to the user. The last step is to develop those functions that you want to expose to the mini app. So what will be the integration mechanisms between mini apps and super apps? The typical example that we mentioned today is when you want to make a payment. So you will have to develop that feature, and what you will expose is an API so that when you're developing that mini app, you can invoke this directly to the super app. This is everything that goes in terms of how you develop the super app. So let's talk about mini apps now. To model and build mini apps, today you don't need extra knowledge apart from what you already know to build a mobile solution with GeneXus. So in the same way that you can use GeneXus to build Android and Apple applications, in the same way and using the same knowledge, you can generate these mini apps. As a matter of fact, the same application that probably today we are publishing in the stores can be also generated as a mini app so that they can be incorporated in these platforms. If there are any additional aspects to be considered, for instance, sometimes super app owners or managers may give some resources, usually graphic resources, that will be contemplated by those that develop mini apps. For instance, we want the payment button, because even though each mini app will have their own graphic identity, we want the button payment to be exactly the same for all mini apps, so that users know that when they get to that point, they will be interacting with the super app. Or maybe the button to close the mini app and go back to the super app. So some interaction designs that will be typical for this integration between mini apps and super apps. The second point to bear in mind is when you're invoking services given by the super app. For instance, if the mini app is going to make a payment, instead of having to implement all that payment platform and integrate with other different payment platforms, what it will do is it will call the payment method from the super app, and it's the super app that will manage that payment. That interaction may be in the background, or it can happen on the screen. So for instance, you could be displaying on the screen the different ways of payment that that user has registered in that super app. And many apps will not have access to that information. They will just be invoking that information, but it's super apps who will be giving the result for that information and will tell you whether or not the payment was successful or if you got a code or if you got an error. The third point is that when you have developed your mini app and you've tried it in your local environment, you will deploy the solution. A mobile solution with GeneXus is basically made up in terms of architecture of two things. First, you have backend services that will be nourishing that application and that can have access to databases or different APIs or services. And the front-end component, that is what you usually compile and you send to the different stores. For example, Google Play or Apple Store. So a mini app solution means that backend services will be deployed exactly in the same way that you would deploy any other mobile application in your structure, depending on what you prefer. And the front-end component, instead of being compiled and published on the store, it will be cataloged in the mini app center. So the result of that generation process with GeneXus already has all the necessary information, which we call metadata, to publish that in the mini app center, where, for example, super app managers will have given you access to make that publication. Once you've published it, it will be subjected to review. So super app managers will take a look at that solution and to try to see whether or not it works together with the super app. And once those tests have been cleared, many apps will be available to be accessed from the super app. So in runtime, what you're going to see is that the super app will be connected through an API to the mini app center to get the list of mini apps that are available and ready for that super app. And once the user selects one of those super apps, you will automatically download that application. You will render it absolutely native in the super app. And then users will begin to interact in that mini app that at the same time will have access to the same backend services. So with GeneXus, you get all these components that will help you to build a full mini app and super app solution. First, we're talking about the capacity to transform any existing native application into a super app. And for that, as I said, we have all the different components and modules and documentation examples on GitHub so that you can very quickly take a look at that and transform your super apps, your applications into super apps. Secondly, we talk about modeling and building mini apps. As I said, this is something that you can do today with GeneXus, thanks to our native mobile generator. You can build this kind of solution. You just need to integrate with these additional modules so that you can interact with super apps. In parallel, we are working already now, and this is in beta, the possibility to build super apps in GeneXus. And last, we are giving you the mini app center. This means that we are giving you infrastructure as a code with a CDK where you can install this mini app center that consists of a back office, a web back office for everything in terms of administration, register, and so on and so forth, and all the APIs that will interact with the super app. So all these components are available in GeneXus and ready to use. So why build super apps with GeneXus? Well, first, because GeneXus will give you all these components and technology so that you can create 100% super app solution. It's the only tool that will give you all these components and technology to build a full super app and mini app solution. Second, because you can convert any native application into a super app thanks to this technology without having to do any kind of rework. You can get any application that has a nice user adoption level made into a super app. We have more than 30 years of experience in the market generating automatic code to build innovative solutions with the minimum effort. Also, we will not only provide you with all the products that make up this ecosystem, but also, thanks to our partners network, we can help you to build a complete super app and mini app solution. For those of you that are interested or want to delve into the development of this kind of solution, in our website, you can find all the information about super apps. And also, you will find a form to reach us so that we can give you some feedback on how to build this new kind of solution or applications. Thank you so much.